die for this one. Another one.
DJ Khaled, shining, yeah. All of this winning, I've been losing my mind. Oh, hold on.
Better make a smile when you see that bitch pull up. Money don't make me happy, and a fella can't make me fancy. We smiling for a whole nother reason. It's all smiles through all four seasons.
Shining, yeah.
All of this winning, I've been losing my mind. Hold on, don't try to slow me down. I dropped the top out the coupe. They try to get at me, ooh. They say I'm sweet just like you. Said everything young.
Petty, I've been winning steady. Yes, all up on your grill, the boy. Popping off back to my dog, yeah, boy. Came out 97 with it 20 years, boy. Oh. All is good, I don't feel bad for it. When you see me smile, you can't be mad at it. Yeah, money don't make me happy, and a fella can't make me fancy. We smiling for a whole nother reason. It's all smiles through all four seasons.
Shining, yeah.
All of this winning, I've been losing my mind. Hold on, don't try to slow me down.
Show, and that's funny, cause I've seen it before. You wanna hold my hand, you wanna hold my dough. You got love for sale, I don't need it. 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 Options, any money and more, had a minute, it was a long time ago. You wanna spend my time, you wanna spend my dough. You got love for sale, I don't need it. 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 I don't need it.
Yeah. about to get into this, girls. It's for all my grown women out there.
I can't wait till I get home so you can turn that cherry out.
Turn that cherry out, turn that cherry out.
I can't wait till I get home so you can turn that cherry out.
Turn that cherry out, turn that cherry out.
I want you to
turn that cherry out, turn that cherry out.
When it drip off on top of your ride,
let me see it here. Lift it up and toss it, babe. I know everything you want. I'ma show you how I stroke. Bring your whip home on top of me. I'ma let you beat it, boss on me. I know everything you want. Give me that daddy long stroke.
I can't wait till I get home so you can tear that cherry out.
Turn that cherry out. Turn that cherry out.
If you're smart.
On BKS1 Radio. Let's go.
This is Essence Atkins, and this is BKS1 Radio.
Hi, this is Melvin Moore, and you're listening to BKS1 Radio.
Yo, check it out. What's the deal? This the chef. Giving a big shout out to my peoples. Big KS, you already know what it is. Salute.
What's up? It's your girl, Monifa, and I'm hanging with BKS1 Radio.
Hi, I'm Ian LaVanzan, and you're listening to BKS1 Radio.
BKS Radio, baby.
Hey, this is Jasmine Guy for BKS1 Radio.
What's going on? This is Lamon Rooker, and this is BKS1 Radio.
Shout out to BKS1, the best kept damn secret in the business.
Hey, what's up? This is Raven Goodwin from BET's Being Mary Jane, and shout out to BKS1.
Hi, this is Leon. You're watching BKS1 Radio.
BKS1. God bless y'all.
Everybody,
thank you so much.
Welcome to BKS1 Radio,
Karima.
The Owl Show.
This doing all my shout outs.
The Owl Show and the first Owl Show of 2019. Yes. I am LaToya Chanel, and I am sitting here, of course, with Miss Queen B. And we are very happy to be here. It is our first Tuesday back. It is our first Tuesday of 2019. And I'm happy to be here.
Me
are you
too.
Happy to be here?
Yes. Okay. Shout out to our beautiful DJ.
Beautiful DJ. You know what? Let's put KT on the screen.
Yeah, we're going to put her on.
All right. There you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
I got some camera time.
Yes.
There you go.
Of course.
No, there you go. Okay. So KT is on the screen
test,
right
test,
there.
Test,
how
test,
are you? Can we hear you?
I don't know.
I mean,
testing, you know, you got that sex work.
Say it again.
Testing 1-2.
That 1-800 voice.
1-900.
Oh. I like that one.
The 1-900 voice.
Why is it 1-900?
Because it is. It's 1-900. Anywho, hi, KT.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm doing good.
You're doing good.
Yes.
All right.
How y'all doing?
Happy New Year.
Yes. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Happy New Year to everybody who is watching. So for everybody who is watching on Queen's B's phone, for everybody who's watching on Instagram, for everybody who is watching on either Facebook or either
hey mom,
WBKS1.com, or if you're listening to us on the TuneIn app right now, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Happy New Year and welcome into 2019. It is our first show of the year. We are here. We are happy. We are
very excited.
Very happy to be here. Happy to start a new year. In the studio with family, and you know what I mean? It's just us in the studio today. We actually have some great guests in the studio with us this month. So to start off the month, you know, you got to get your mind right. It's the beginning of the year. So we're going to have Dr. Hardy, who is going to be in the studio with us in the next coming weeks as well. And she's going to make sure we got our mind right. And, you know, you got to set the tone. You got to set the foundation for the rest of the year. So she's going to be in studio with us. And shout out to Do It All Dupree Kelly from Lords of the Underground, who is going to be in a studio with us as well this month before he goes out on tour. So we are going to have some amazing people in the studio with us for the rest of the month. So you guys got to make sure you stay tuned for that.
We're going to have some A Natural in the building.
Okay, A Natural is going to be in the building with us.
His
okay.
CD.
Yes.
We're going to have him coming up. I mean, we have a lot of shows.
We got to get Steve.
A lot of shows lined up with you guys. Hey, Patrick. Hey, Happy New Year.
Patrick, I got to talk to you. It's 2019. I need to know what's up.
Yeah. So we have a lot, a great deal going on, and we are super excited to present to you and keep presenting to you a great show with great topics.
Great content.
We're going to delve into so many things this year. Yeah. If you think we were transparent before, we are going to be more transparent.
I don't know. And not only that, more transparent.
Not only that. Not only that. I just want to delve into topics that maybe we haven't.
Yeah, of course. Going,
and or topics, have topics and look, you know, in a different angle.
Of course.
So I kind of want to do that.
Right.
So, hey, Erica.
Right. Definitely do that for 2019. You know, same day, Tuesdays from 7 to 8:30 right here on BKS1 Radio. And it'll be myself, Queen B. And we are in here with either DJ KT,
the
voice, who has been rocking out, or DJ Sassy. And that's the family. That's the family right here. We are a family, and we will be rocking out for 2019. But again, this is our first show of the year, so it's just us.
It's just us
in the studio. We're going to be talking about, you know, all of the hot topics. Obviously, everybody knows that Robert Kelly is a hot topic right now, so we are definitely going to delve into that. I want to say we're going to delve into it a little bit, but I feel like once people start talking about this, it just does not stop. I don't care if you're at work. I don't care if it's on social media. Right. I know some people are tired of it already, but listen, it's our first show back, so we got to get it out. Mm-hmm. So for everybody,
A lot has happened.
So for everybody who is, you know, tuning in, you know what I mean? You guys make sure you chime in and let us know what it is that you guys think about, you know, all of it. So in the meantime, Queen B, I want to just go into the fact that it is the new year.
Yes.
And I know people don't make resolutions anymore
because
that's just not the wave. But I want to know what are you accepting this year and what are you not accepting this year, Queen B?
Well,
okay.
Fakeness.
Oh,
we talked about that today.
We talked about whackness.
Whackness.
No,
I'm
whackness.
Sorry.
Can we start a whack campaign?
I'm going to be honest. I'm allergic to whackness.
No whackness.
So this year, I will not be tolerating
whackness.
Anything remotely close to whack.
Whack. No whackness.
Nothing.
No whack. We got to make some t-shirts.
No.
Hashtag
no whackness. It can't stay here.
What I really want is like a shirt that says whack-ish. With the red thing and the thing like that.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like
I think we should.
For 2019. Mm-hmm.
So, let me tell you, you know, 2018 was a great year, but I think it basically is preparing me for this dynamic year that I'm about to
embark upon
this year.
Yeah.
So, I'm super excited because I will not allow anyone to steal my joy.
Ooh.
I will not allow anyone to steal my peace. Uh-huh. I will definitely, hey Lolita and hey Marissa, I will definitely not allow anybody in my space.
Oh.
So, and I'm not even allowing you to, I'm saying I won't allow you to steal my peace, but I won't allow you in my space. Mm-hmm. It just won't happen. So if you see me, a lot of people going to say, maybe she acting funny.
Get the shirts out ASAP.
Yeah, got you.
We got to get these shirts out. Uh-huh.
Okay. So what I won't do is I won't allow anybody in my space that doesn't belong there.
You know, everybody talks about energy, mm-hmm, energy, mm-hmm, energy. Like that's the hip happening. Don't I sound old? That's the hip happening word is energy. But however, I to protect my energy, I have the right not to deal with you.
Right.
I have the right not to deal with you.
That. I had to learn.
No. To protect me.
Yeah.
And my energy and where I want my head space to be. Mm-hmm. I have the right not to engage in your foolishness.
Can I just tell you?
What's up, Scoop? Can we shout out Scoop?
Hey, Scoop.
Scoop, reporter. Everything that you do for the NBA, for the NFL, for every single thing you do in every single magazine you're in. Shout out to Scoop Brandon right here.
Great year.
We know it's going to be amazing, Scoop. We already know it. Go ahead.
My thing is I want to add to that.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to add because we share some of the same sentiments.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't care who you are.
Right.
I don't care if you're family.
Right.
I don't care if you my kids.
Blood, no blood.
I don't care who you are. I will not allow you this year to steal anything from me. Everything.
No whackness.
I owe it to myself.
Mm-hmm.
I'm coming for everything that's mine.
Do it.
I'm coming for everything that's mine. And I will not allow anyone in my circle that's either going to steal that or taint that or get me distracted.
Hey, cuz.
I will not do that. Uh-huh. So that's my sentiments for Hey Shonda, Hey Sandra.
Uh-huh. Happy birthday to my cousin who just turned in.
Yes.
Happy birthday, Shonda. Love you.
I don't care who it is. I will not. So you can say she's acting funny. You can say she, whatever you want to say she is. It will not bother me.
Right.
That for 2019.
Right. Okay. Well, I'm with you.
I want a peaceful year. No, because I don't want to be involved in no drama. I don't want to be involved in nothing. If you trying to bring that to my life, if you trying to bring whackness,
no whackness.
Lying,
no whackness,
deceit, or anything like that, it can't stay here. Uh-huh. I'm sorry. It just can't.
Ty said, not accepting anything below my peace level this year.
Ooh,
right there.
I like that. Ooh,
and yeah, that's Jill why we're turning up in March when we go to Atlanta.
So, we're turning 40 this year.
You say I got real quiet. Oh, wait.
Look,
look.
Ooh.
Toya.
Look, sis.
I mean, Chanel.
Look, sis. Wait, no. well, I could be by myself.
They're referring to LaToya and B.
I'm like, whoa.
I'm not included.
Okay, we
in
are
40 club.
We are turning 40 this year. Anyway, so I'm doing 40 to 40.
Good for you.
I'm doing 40 to 40, and that means that everything that I have not had a chance to do in life that I always wanted to do for the 40 days prior to my the 39 days prior to my birthday, I'm going to complete those things.
Do it, sis.
So y'all are going to see some crazy things.
Well, I don't have the days leading up to my birthday. However, I really plan on enjoying myself all year long. Like,
well, I have the first birthday in my friend.
Yeah,
I'm the oldest.
She's the oldest. So she's older than me. So she's the elder, you know.
Yes. Oh, yeah. We'll be in Atlanta. I'll share that with you, Keita.
She's older.
My cousin who's in Atlanta.
Yeah, she's older.
Well, I'll share that with you, and I'll tell you what
we're
coming from.
She's a lot older. So she.
Anyway. I am not a lot older. You really get that off while I'm over here talking. I am not a lot older.
She's a lot older than you. Me. Like, I don't even know. Because
she still look like she's 15.
I don't even know what she's talking about.
That's why she's saying
she's
that.
She's so old. Anyway, no, but seriously. From the first day to the last, and God willing beyond, my plan is to enjoy everything. And I'm not saying I didn't enjoy everything all these other years, but I am living on purpose, and I am making a point to make sure I am thoroughly enjoying everything and weeding out any negativity and weeding out anyone who does not want to be in my space.
I love y'all all.
Or if y'all are in my space and you don't have my best interests at heart, you got to go. Like, if we ain't on the same page, we don't have the same, you know, you got to go. I understand, you know, adversity is necessary, and iron sharpens iron, and I get all of that. However, that's just the space that I am in.
Yeah.
That's the space I am in. Mm-hmm. So you got to go, because this energy
iron sharpens iron, but I'm a pillow this year.
This energy
feather.
that I have right now is what I plan to have all year.
Yeah, no.
You know, God willing.
I just want to, honestly, I want to
God
lead
willing.
This year. Lord, I want to lead please. This year. I just want to, I just want to live my best life.
I would like to.
I would like to live my best life. So.
So that's what, now that's what we on this year. KT, what you on this year? For 2019, what you got?
I am not going to be worried about leaving anybody behind. I got things to do.
Yes. Shout out to my DJ who says she got things to do.
I got things to do. I'm a good person. I'm a happy person. I like to live life and have fun. So either you are on the train or you are off the train.
She
and
said,
I ain't gonna worry about it. I'm going to just keep going.
She said either you bought a ticket or you didn't.
That's it.
Okay.
You heard it from her.
You brought a ticket or you didn't.
You heard it first here, 2019.
Right. No refunds.
No refunds.
If you bought a ticket, no refunds.
Not getting your money back.
You off the train.
Just get off.
Just off. That's it.
All right.
You get off.
I like that analogy.
We're not getting hit by trains, but you getting kicked off trains.
Yeah.
You're not getting hit by them.
Yeah.
You getting kicked off trains.
You on a track.
You
on a track.
You're not on the track getting hit.
No.
You getting kicked off.
You getting kicked off.
Okay.
I like that. Kick them off.
Kick them off.
Kick them off.
I get it. I'm with it.
Don't look back. Don't ask no questions.
None at all.
Don't ask if they're right.
I mean, trains don't
turn
around.
You know. No,
they don't.
They keep going.
That's it.
They keep.
Hey, T.
They keep moving forward.
Happy New Year.
I get it. Listen. I'm with you. All right, so that's us for 2019.
Yeah.
You guys can put it in the comments and in the chat. You know, what are some of your
2019, what it is you're accepting and what it is you're not accepting, and let us know what it is you guys
just want to make the announcement. My page is going to discontinue. Please go to the Only Woman Wear High Heels page and talk to us, please.
No more
discontinuing
your page.
No, just for today, just for now. I want them to visit our page.
Yeah, go to
just for now.
HH. Yes. Everybody.
Only women wear
high heels. You guys can go in there and talk to us. In the meantime, though, all right, so that's our, 2019.
Yeah.
What we got going on. Like Queen B said, go over to Al and let us know what it is that you got going on. And we'll read off some of your comments, in the midst of the show. But in the meantime, so what we said we were discussing today was hot topics. Norm, you brought back food? Okay. So
what we didn't get out.
Look, you brought back food? Chips? You brought potato chips? We want to start the year with just chips? Like, I'm confused. Look, you just in time for
the
that.
Owner just walked in.
Look, you just in time for that. So anyway, all right. So can we start
shout
with
shout out
biggest?
To Norm?
Yeah, shout out to Norm who ain't sharing potato chips. Listen, no. I don't want to eat that. I'm good. No, I'm fine.
It don't got hot sauce on them.
Yeah. So listen, can we start with the? Oh, you want to lead up to the biggest topic, or
yes.
Do you want to start? So what?
So
let's start with this government shutdown. Okay.
What do you think?
I'm at a loss.
So he is
oh, brown. That's good.
He's upset because they won't build
45.
The wall. 45. I said he because yeah, I don't. No, no. I don't 45.
Wanna, 45 is upset.
I don't want to talk about him or anything.
You know, I got hair on my chest. So yeah, thank you. So yes, 45.
You can mix mine, Norm. Thank you.
45 is upset.
He's upset.
So he is. Oh yeah, mix mine too. So he is shutting down the government now. Some of the some of everything. No. Stop. Stop. So okay. So I'm sorry. I'm losing
red
my
cups
train
are
of thought.
Building.
Red cups are in the building, so I'm losing my train of thought. Okay. So with him shutting down the government, what does that mean for us? So as we're seeing, I saw a story where they are now going to issue tax returns. Is that the latest?
Yes, they did say that.
Okay, so we are going to get our tax returns. So you're not going to have a bunch of people storming the gates of the White House because I just knew that was going to happen.
Yeah.
If people did not start getting tax returns in January, February, and in March, I knew that people were going to storm the White House.
I wonder if flights are going down low, though.
Well, with TSA workers, a lot of them are not getting paid.
So I have a friend who actually posted and she said, please stop asking me about flights. I'm not getting paid to go to work.
Wow.
So she is like, she's like, I'm not beat.
Now I want to know, does it also affect like city officials because they're state employees? So does that affect like city of Plainfield, city of Newark? Like, I know they have budget for that already, but can they continue to, are they getting paid?
No, they're not getting paid. No.
They're not either?
No. Isn't it all the same?
I don't know.
It's all coming from the same. I don't believe they're getting paid. I think it's crazy. I think 2 years in a row. Well, not 2 years in a row. Two presidents.
Okay.
We went through this shutdown thing.
Okay.
Not as long, of course.
Right.
But we went through the shutdown thing, and I think it's unacceptable.
Now, my question is, why is the impeachment process
so
being delayed?
Are they going to impeach him at the end?
Like, right. That's my question. Like, why is this being delayed? Like, what is there a reasoning behind this? And again, I'm not a political science major.
How much evidence they need?
And,
someone tell us. On our,
like what do you need to impeach a president? Now, obviously,
they clearly have
enough evidence
to know that he did whatever he did with Russia.
Right, that was from the beginning. So
my cousin said, I know Homeland is included. Not sure about state.
Okay, so state employees might be okay, but government officials.
Like police,
FBI agents and different things like that. Because I know the people in the FBI building are not getting paid. And the FBI building's right next to my job. They're not getting paid.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, they're not getting paid.
And they still got to go in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That is. That sucks.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Wow. Okay. Well, I don't know. So my thing is, I'm just trying to figure out what the impeachment process. I'm going to have to go home and read like I'm in a political science course.
I don't know
course.
Who it affects. I think it's clearly sad, of course. Why does KT get, why do we get red cups?
DJs.
Oh, okay.
Whatever.
Y'all suck.
Okay, listen. So, does anybody, KT, do you know about the impeachment process?
I don't. I am not a political person, like you said. Mm-hmm. So, I am not too
red
knowledgeable
cups
about
for
that.
For 2019.
Okay. But I would like to know. I definitely would like to know.
Yeah, I'm going to look into that. All right. So, that's that. No.
That little piece.
It's a new year.
Jeez. Oh, my God. Yeah. Do y'all see this? Anywho. So, anyway. All right. So that
let
is
us know who's getting paid and who's not. Not that I can help. I wish I had the money to help. But my thing is that unacceptable. I do know that they made a lot of posts and things like that, which said that you can actually ask for your mortgage to be put on the end of your loan.
The back end of your loan.
You put your mortgage payment on the back end. Yeah. So I know that they have certain things where you can tell them that, you know, you work for the government and there are certain things that you're privy to. Mm-hmm. Literally, please, whomever, I don't know what it is for. I know the WIC offices were not giving out milk to the children. Wow. I did see that. I'm not sure what they're doing or what happened with the food stamps or anything, or going forward, what's going to happen. But I just think that everybody should literally save what you can so you can kind of get through the month. Mm. And I know, you know, that's why, you know, they say create the rainy day funds because mortgages and car notes are what you can ask to be pushed back. So I just ask that you guys... you guys just hold on to whatever money you have and don't go frivolously spending.
I think the rainy day funds should be like at home too.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know,
because absolutely.
I feel like that'll be like the next thing at some point where the bank accounts or something get crazy. So.
There's going to be a lot of people behind on rent.
Right.
There's going to be a lot of people behind on mortgage. You know, and then someone asked him.
No, Ish said it depends on how your department is funded. Mm-hmm. Some are federally funded and some are locally funded. State agencies receive funding federally and locally. Contingency plans will identify the non-essential employees versus the essential employees during furloughs. So,
hey, Shantasia.
What's up, Bass, from the 4U radio show out in New York.
So...
But okay, so
how my cousin say no crab legs this month?
Oh, with the EBT card? Yeah, you know what?
She ain't right.
You ain't right.
And she said food stamps is funded through
federal
and state,
which means
the camera now. So that's what I'm telling you. And I'm literally not trying to be funny or anything like that. But save what you have. Don't go selling them, spending them, or doing whatever you generally do, frivolously spending. Please keep that food in the house you don't want. And please be careful. And if you could help someone out that's going through this, please help someone out. Because, you know, again... You know, a lot of things happen when things don't get paid. People start wanting to rob people. People start doing stuff that they generally would not do.
I don't work for the government, but if anybody want to help fund me right now, y'all could just hit my DM, and I'm gonna send y'all my email address for I don't use Cash App. What I use? What is it called? What's it called? Venmo.
Venmo.
Yes. Thank you. So y'all can begin to. Support me and my family with the Venmo app, but I'll send that to y'all like after the show.
I just want to say like seriously, this is no joke. I just want to say that, so be mindful.
Yeah,
please. Definitely. You know,
in all seriousness, yes. Be mindful in all seriousness, yes. All right, so that's Trump. Let's go from Trump to Centonia.
Why August? I don't know.
Why she gotta wait till August?
We're talking about Centonia now. Let me tell y'all this. I'm gonna be honest with you.
I don't like it.
I don't like it. I like the fact that she can see the light of day.
That yes.
I'm gonna be honest with you. I get teary eyed thinking about it.
Right.
Because I literally, y'all don't understand that I really, really prayed that girl be released.
Right.
Because to me, everything done to her from the time she was born up until the time she did what she did, a lot of people are not understanding the story. And they're saying, why didn't she kill her pimp? Guess what? That guy was her it. Mm-hmm. That guy was her limit. Yeah. That guy was her, I'm done, I'm tired of this. That was what it was. So she might have lost her mind at that point. The one thing I am still praying for restoration for her.
Yeah,
because in every way, because
she's gonna need that
mentally. One, she's a celebrity now. Mm-hmm. You got to understand that by default. Mm-hmm. Two, so she gets a lot of attention and everything like that. Two, I just want her mental status to be okay. Mm-hmm. Because when you're caged for that long, right, and you've dealt with that many things, you just don't know, you know, what to do. So I am praying for every aspect. One, that she just is restored. Two, that she continually gets the help that she needs.
Right,
three,
right,
that she transitions back into life with, because she was young when she went in.
She was 16.
She was 16.
So we're talking about the story of Santonya Brown, who was just granted clemency after 15 years in prison. Mm-hmm. for killing the man who purchased her. For, you know, obviously as a sex slave. She was granted clemency and she will be released in August of this year.
Yes.
Again, I'm just kind of. What'd you say, KT?
How do you send someone to jail?
I'm not sure the laws, you know, where she lived or where she was. But I know self-defense or whatever you want to call it is not prevalent in like many states, or just established, right, I should say, in many states.
She was in
Tennessee. Agree with you.
She was in
Tennessee.
Because
so
even with the core of the story.
Yes. You didn't have a heart. You didn't feel any type of way about anything. You brought her. You brought her. And let me tell you, her life, we're talking about, a lot of times it gets overshadowed by what she did, but her life leading up to that was horrible.
Yeah. Yeah.
Was horrible. So that's my thing. So I just want, going forward, she'll be released in August. I pray that nothing happens. She'll get out and she'll be fine as far as, you know, her days. She'll be on parole for 10 years. So I pray that she is just not introduced to anything, caught to anything, go back to any type of lifestyle that she was familiar with. Because you just never know. Yeah. But I just pray for restoration in her spirituality, in her mentally, in her physically, just everything. I know that you can't forget certain things that you go through, but I just wish that she just uses this to catapult to the next level and just catapult into
life. This is a new life for her. Again, yeah. She was 16 years old when she went in jail.
Absolutely.
That was what, in 2004? She was 16 when she went in jail. She's an adult. She's a grown woman now. You know what I mean? Like, life is 15 years later. She's a 30-something-year-old woman.
Antoine says, those celebrities that supported her and spoke on her behalf need to maintain that same energy. Energy meaning getting her the support she needs to transition back into civilization.
They have the funds.
Yeah. And why not? Why not start a GoFundMe for her?
I agree.
Why not start a GoFundMe so when she comes out, she does not have to scrounge around for clothes. She doesn't have to scrounge around, because let's be real. This is a grown woman who is not going to know what it is to be a grown woman
and to take care of herself.
In survival mode.
She's never taken care of herself.
No,
she's never done that before.
No,
she's never done that.
Hey, Jalil. So let's just pray her strength.
Right.
Let's just pray her strength in, you know, just in society, to acclimate in society in the proper way.
Right.
That's it. But I cried, y'all.
Yeah.
I cried. Yeah.
You shed some tears.
I shed some tears.
You poured one out for the homies.
I did, because I just know that life, not that I physically lived that life, but I've encountered a great deal of females and young people that their choices were really limited.
Right.
It's something that they were birthed into.
Right.
It's something that they don't know anything different from what was
taught.
Well,
her mother says she drank heavily while she was pregnant with her, and she has neurological,
developmental delays.
Issues.
Yes, she has delays.
So she already has a strike against her. You know what I mean? And the fact that you are sold as a sex slave, you know what I mean? the psychological damage from that alone is insane. You know what I mean? She has she has a lot to work through for the rest of her years. So hopefully she does.
And she's a beautiful girl.
Get the help that she needs when she does get out in August.
You know, and it's a statement. I mean, if I could ever talk to her, just there is a time in life when we are little girls, and before the world tells us what we are to be or what we can't do, or, you know, or life, before life actually, we have dreams and we have visions and we have dreams and we have goals and we have whatever.
Yeah.
But just as a little girl, I just want her to go back to that. Go back to, it's hard to go back to because you've been through so much.
You know, that's very.
It is. No. Definitely. But go back to being whatever you want to be.
Right.
Because it all starts in your mind. Mm-hmm. We're caged in our mind first. Yeah. So I just want her to.
Well, we allow people to cage it.
Exactly. So I just kind of want her to. I just want her to just like do speak to young people, come out, mentor, you know, do what you need to do to save somebody else. But also just, you know, understand that we got people praying for you.
Yeah. Well, there's people backing you, so hopefully
thank you, Jalil.
She will get the help that she needs, and hopefully she will come out and be able to live a healthy life.
Absolutely.
With therapy and with support. Mm-hmm. And you know, be able to find some joy and find some happiness and find some freedom.
Because it's,
you know,
available.
What I mean? But that's what life is about.
Yes, it is.
Life is about the freedom and the autonomy to be who it is that you want to be. You know what I mean? And the joy that you receive from doing that. You know what I mean? So
I think our next topic will delve into that.
What?
Because there's a lot of snatching of
delve
innocence.
Into what?
There's a lot of snatching of innocence from young people.
Of course. What you saying, KT?
I was just going to say, also pray that she, when she gets out, she's surrounded by good people.
Yes. Yeah, with a good, you know,
support system.
Yeah.
And knows that'll lead her and not use her or pimp her in a different way.
Right, because I mean, it happens. Right.
It happens.
Because it happens.
Hey, Steph.
Because it happens.
So I'm glad she's going to see the light of day. She is
in
not going to spend the rest
of her
life.
Coming out in the summertime.
And let me tell you something. I'm going to be rooting from afar.
Yeah.
If I ever get the opportunity just to hug her, I would.
Right.
And I'm just super excited
that
she actually gets to get out. And there are so many people just locked behind bars with that story, right?
Yes.
And they don't get to see the light of day. And for whatever reason, God would choose her to be that vessel that gets out. So. Right. I mean, it is what it is.
All right. So listen, we've been going through hot topics, everybody. It's just us. It's just us in the studio. So we wanted to start
to talk about this.
Listen, we wanted to start the year off with what it is we're accepting and not accepting in 2019. We went through that. No whack-ish in 2019. If it's whack, we are not about it and we are not accepting it. You know, obviously there's things that are out of your control. You know, I got some things in my life that are out of my control right now that are completely whack. Shout out to Jess, you watching right now. I got to deal with some whack stuff in some places. You know what I'm saying? But I'm just saying, it's just whack. It's just whack. You know what I mean? But that's out of my control until I can get away from the whackness. But in the meantime,
I haven't cleared out
not
everything within my control, but I'm just telling you that I'm working on it day
by
day.
If it's in my control, it's in my control.
Yeah.
If it's out of my control, then that just is what it is. But as far as dealing with any whack-ish in 2019,
I'm not.
And we're going to get these t-shirts going. We're going to sell them for $9.95. Look, because it's about currency and multiple sources of income. Mm-hmm. Okay.
No, so we really are.
That's what we're about. So
we're
going to sell these no whack-ish t-shirts for $9.95, you know, because I gotta go off the late night channel 16, you know, 1995 prices.
Three,
you know what
payments.
I'm saying? Three payments.
Do
you need three payments?
Three payments.
If you need three payments of, you know, I'm bad at math.
PayPal us.
What's $9.95 divided by three?
I can't with you.
I'm bad at math.
I can't with you.
Listen, I ain't never said that math was my strong suit. Y'all know
divided
that.
Divided by three.
Okay.
331.
331.
Just round it up to 332.
Right. So listen. Three payments.
Three payments. We're doing
t-shirts.
332.
You see what I'm saying? Three, y'all listening?
Yes, sis.
Three payments.
We are listening.
Of three. Okay, we got a buyer. Jesse says she needed one in a small.
Okay.
Okay.
We got you. We got no.
You need the payment plan in the three.
We are definitely doing that because we are not doing wax stuff in 2019.
Like you let me.
So. R. Kelly, let's roll.
Wait, can I get my money?
Whoa. We won't get the money.
Oh. Three payments of $332.
Oh, us like you owe your rent.
My cousin Tay says she's in. Okay. Three payment. Okay, cuz. Your birthday coming up. Size small. That's what I'm talking about.
In your family.
Shut up. Stop doing that. Stop hating. Listen.
Look, Antoine said extra large.
Oh, extra large. You got extra.
We got three people.
I'm with you, Antoine. Keita, I know we about to get it. Look, she like Woosah.
Three payments of $332, people. We got three orders so far. Do we got any more? Anybody? No whack-ish? In 2019, y'all let me know because we're going to get these t-shirts popping. We're going to
get these t-shirts.
As a matter of fact, I'm going to just start wearing mine.
Yeah.
You know, to work.
Yeah, I want a certain color. Let me know.
Listen, no whack-ish in 2019. We got an extra large, extra large, extra large over here. We got two smalls over there.
And her
I'm
family.
I'm just saying, shut up.
Why is everybody a small?
Hush!
I'm just asking why everybody's a small. Because if my family get here, they're going to be like, large,
because
extra large.
You know why?
Give me a 2X.
Let me big up my family. Because, number one, she is a black belt. But she is a black belt. Can I put your business
out
there?
A black belt in my family.
Can I put your business out there, Tay? She got four kids, and she's still a small.
Yeah.
Okay.
Look at that.
Okay.
It's the jeans.
Okay. She got four, and she's still a small.
It's the jeans.
She's still a small.
Jalil said extra, extra large.
Oh, we got an extra, extra large over here.
I'm with you, brother.
Jalil, shout out to Jalil Grady over here. Yes, so that's why we still small.
Yeah, my family thicker than Snickers, though. Shout out to my cousins.
You know what? Whatever.
I got my twin cousin listening right now.
Whatever. Listen, so shout hey, out to Shahid. Everybody that is going to order these t-shirts from us, because yes. We're really serious about this. No whack-ish in 2019. Maybe we should do it in a hashtag out. No, we really about to start something. You know what? 2019 is already looking good.
Money, 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 money.
It's already looking good for us. Nah. All right, let's get into this topic, y'all.
All right, anyway, we'll be talking about the...
Listen, we done went through the government. We have gone through Centonia Brown. We have gone through 2019. We're going,
our last topic
no
for the
whack-ish.
Night.
No whack-ish.
Hey, Les, my brother.
I had to give some time for this.
For what?
Wait, Chase, my little cousin said he want a men's medium. Okay? Because, well.
It's a lot going on in your family.
Chase said a
somebody need to eat.
No, Chase is a child.
Oh, okay.
Like, Chase is a child. Men's
y'all
medium.
Need to eat.
Trust me.
Okay, Keita said, "Come on, we stalling." She got 32%. That's my cousin.
Sorry.
That's my twin cousin.
Sorry. Okay, listen. Last topic for tonight in our hot topics. Okay.
Why my cousin Keita said he's small?
He's a child. A child.
Hell no. Okay. Our family thick.
All right, listen. Y'all ready? Last topic for
ready.
Tonight.
Ba-dum-bum, ba-dum-bum. All right. What are we talking about?
Robert Kelly.
Do you have your passport? Do you have
your... I'm sorry. Sing it for us again. Hold up. Sing it for us again.
Do y'all hear this? Do you
sing
hear
it.
This?
Sing it for
hey,
us.
Ethan.
Good. I'm saying, that pedophile, that creep, singing, do you have your passport?
Where was he singing it at?
Did you get your shots?
Where he singing that at?
You wanna come with Rob to America? America.
Oh! Where he sing that at?
Ethiopian concert.
Okay.
Pedophile, he's a creep.
He trying to recruit him
He recruiting in Ethiopia, y'all.
All right, then. So y'all heard it from the man himself, Norm.
Robert Kelly, everybody.
So,
I don't know where to
begin.
But I'm going to
just, let me begin. Let me begin.
You got it, sis.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I'm going to just tell you.
Let's say, surviving R. Kelly. So for anybody who has been sleeping under a rock, the Surviving R. Kelly 6-part, 3-night series on Lifetime aired last Thursday night, Friday night, and Saturday night.
Right.
If you did not see it, you can go on demand.
and you can watch all six parts. He's singing that in the studio. You can watch all six parts on Lifetime on demand, and you guys can catch up on exactly what it is we're talking about if you have not seen it. So Surviving R. Kelly was a documentary from the standpoint of some of the victims of R. Kelly's alleged abuse and alleged pedophilia over the years. I mean, from the 90s up until, you know, I think it ended in May. It did not end, but the series itself went up to May of 2018, May of last year.
Okay.
So it's Surviving R. Kelly. Your cousin is right. It is Surviving R. Kelly and Friends, because he can't do all of this stuff by himself. He needs a team of people to keep people. So you're right. Mm-hmm. In the meantime, okay, Queen B, you wanna get started?
I don't know where to begin, but I've actually seen Facebook divided.
Oh, yes, it's divided. I'm gonna be honest.
I have seen Facebook divided about the R. Kelly thing, and I am so confused. I'm so confused for people who are females. I'm so confused for people who have sisters and mothers. I'm so confused for people who have daughters. I just watched someone on say, how y'all know it's true. What I do know, hear me. Even if I didn't know about the other girls, what I do know to be true is the fact that he did marry Aaliyah she was 15. He was 27. That's not alleged.
Stop right there. Did y'all see, though, because now I'm gossiping. Did y'all see, though, when they said he had to marry her because she was in trouble? So she was pregnant?
Yes.
So Aaliyah was pregnant by R. Kelly. At 15.
Did they ever say what happened to the baby, though?
She was in trouble, so they had to go get her and take her up to, take her up to Chicago? Yeah, so she was pregnant.
So listen to this. They got married at 15, but they said that the woman's account was that she started having sex with him at 14.
Right.
So my thing is, I know that part to be true. All of us do. All of us do. I don't care what Dame Dash, everybody's like venting about him. I don't care about anybody else. I don't.
Well, Dame Dash said that Aaliyah.
No, I know.
Would tell
what I'm
him
saying is they tried to pick story. Him apart too.
Yeah.
What I'm trying to say is that part we know to be true, right? That's all I need to know.
Yeah, she had an abortion. Yep.
I don't need to know anything else. All I need to know is that that's what happened. Now, Sparkle and her niece, we know that to be true. It was him in the video, and they said it was the brother. It was him in the video, and Sparkle knows.
Don't put that on Carrie like that.
Sparkle knows who her niece is. Even if no other family member wants to come out, Sparkle knows who her niece is. She said she had the same hairstyle that she had. That's how she clearly
you
knew
know why? Because,
it was her niece.
Because most 14-year-olds
have the same
have
hairstyle.
Have the same hairstyle.
Okay. So those two instances are true.
Right.
My problem is, how is it hard to believe everybody else? How is it hard to believe? And then everybody's defending him. And then you got people that worked for him telling the story. So what did they get out of lying on him?
Right.
What did they get? I've heard, let's talk about the Catholic Church. Let's talk about it all, because this particular topic I get so vexed about because we sweep it under the rug. Yes, uncles and aunts and cousins and brothers and all types of people have been touching children and whomever, for girl and boy,
girl,
and we're sweeping it under the rug.
Can we say girl and boy?
And this is it's crazy because it's this fast behind girl. Again, I heard the best statement. The best statement was, I don't care how fast the girl is. If a male that is an adult is not trying to catch that fast little girl, then she can't be caught.
Can I say
period?
This? Can I say this, though?
I'm angry at the... Hold up. I'm angry at just everybody being divided about this. Oh, we need more proof. Oh, yeah, Zimmerman killed Trayvon. And did they need more proof? They didn't want to indict him. There's so many instances that happened that we didn't need more proof. But you guys, because of this man's music, you actually, he's exempt.
I want to just say this. I mean, because we said it's 2019, right? We said it's 2019. So we say we saying everything, right? So since we saying everything, I want to talk about molestation mm-hmm. being a part of the fabric in the African American culture. Because, you know, there are some things that we laugh off. There are some things that we don't take seriously. And we're talking about him with the young girls, but you touched on a point where we're not talking about is young boys.
Right.
And you're dealing with a culture now where people are starting to speak, but people did not speak previous to this.
Not at all.
How many women, for all of my women who are watching now, and you can take it lighthearted or you can take it seriously, but I'm gonna say this to you. How many men did you date? And when you ask them when they lost their virginity, they all said an astronomically young age
to an older.
But the chick was always older.
Mm-hmm.
Now, whether you want to call that molestation or not, you got to call a spade, it is what it is. If he 10, 11, 12 years old, but loses his virginity to an 18, 19 year old babysitter, then it is what it is.
Yes.
And even though it's not reported, and even though most men are not going to complain about that, the fact of the matter is that molestation, unfortunately, runs rampant in our culture. And whether you choose to see it or not, and whether you choose to admit it or not, and whether you choose to tell the truth about it or not, it is what it is. And we all know it. I am about to be 40 years old, and I have dated and I have talked to plenty of men who talked about things that have happened to them as a child. So it's not just little girls. It's not just little girls at all. It is all of us, because unfortunately this is running rampant in our culture, and people are acting like it's not. So for the people that are saying, how do you know it's true? How do you know it's true? At the end of the day, we know it's true because we know the stories that our friends tell us. Yeah. We know the stories of our family members. Everybody, and it's so funny because at Black people, we make light of everything because I feel like that is just how we get through adversity in life. Everybody knows you don't walk past Uncle So-and-so room. You don't leave Uncle So-and-so with them kids. You don't leave Cousin So-and-so with them kids.
You gotta get dressed when such and such come over.
But right. And we laugh about it, and don't you sit on so-and-so lap, and don't you go in the room with so-and-so. And even though we laugh about it, and even though we make light of it, molestation, unfortunately, is a part of our culture. It's completely unacceptable, but why is it so far-fetched that R. Kelly would have this frame of mind when we know friends, cousins, family members, mothers,
same
fathers, it's the exact same story. The difference is he has money. The difference is the spotlight is going to be shown on him because of the fact that he has money and he's luring people in. But your uncle was luring people in. Let's just be real about it.
With R. Kelly's money.
Without R. Kelly's money. Your uncle was luring little girls in. Your aunt was luring little boys in. Your cousin was one of the ones that took the virginity of this 10-year-old boy, that 11-year-old boy, that 12-year-old boy. It is what it is. It is what it is. So please, let's not act like this is not happening everywhere. And I'm going to take it a step further, because it's not just African-American culture. Absolutely. As well. Because, mind you, if Robert Kelly decides to move out of the United States and take a child bride in any other country, on any other continent, on planet Earth, it's okay.
Yep.
Are we really acting like a 13-year-old, a 14-year-old bride in the continent of Africa, in Australia, in Europe, in Asia is taboo? No, it's not. Actually, it's the norm. So it's our whole being as a species that has this culture of molestation
embedded
of children.
It's the fabric of who we are. Right. It is in the fabric of who we are.
And it's not okay. And it's like, and we are just talking about it now, and we're just getting to the point where it's not okay now. But you talking about in the last 2 years with a Me Too movement, you talking about in the last 10 years
when it's hundreds
with,
of years
with
that,
therapy
yeah.
and everything else that is a do new remember, concept.
Do you remember they were actually the girls were doing the you know in Africa, you know they were.
They were being mutilated.
Yeah. You know, for and
they were
I'm
cutting
I could,
off
yeah,
their clitoris.
Cutting off their clitoris and things like that.
Yeah.
And do you remember that they were getting pregnant early, like 9, 10 years old? Mm-hmm. I just want to read some of the comments before we mm-hmm. go on. But Lakita says, I don't believe Sparkle lying. She lost her career for the truth. Keita said, not in our family, we out them and we know who doing what. The ones that are, Lester said, the ones that are telling the story needs to go to jail, too.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Keita said,
because he can't hold people hostage by himself.
Yeah. Keita said, can't no child catch an adult who don't like kids.
But can we talk about the parents?
Go ahead, KT.
So you can shed some
go
light
ahead,
on that.
KT. Go ahead.
Huh? Yeah. She just talked
yeah,
low.
Yeah, she talked low. You know, she got a
1-900. Yeah, but no, I feel like the parents should take a good amount of the blame.
Absolutely.
As well, because I know what type of father I had.
Me too.
And there is no way that I'm coming home telling him that I'm going to go with some grown man
to a hotel
to
audition.
Or to, you know, take off with my music career or whatever that case. Like, even watching them sit there, they were too calm for me.
Right.
Some of them were a little bit upset, but they were just too calm.
Can I just
for
ask
me.
Something?
Right, right.
Not to cut you off, but can I just ask, who did R. Kelly put on?
None of them.
Who? No. I just want to know. Sparkle. No,
that was the only
Sparkle.
One.
But who but did he right. put on? What young
like,
girl
who, like, who was
came
his protege?
Out, yeah.
Who
what,
was his protege?
Tell me what young girl. Let's just answer this. What young girl came out a star after all these years?
None of them.
Under
did.
Him.
None of them did.
Who?
She wasn't young, that young, though.
Selena
and he tried it with her.
Selena
she got an interview.
Selena
has an interview.
Young.
Yeah.
Shout out to Selena.
Shout out to Selena, who brought her husband in the studio. And y'all
yeah.
can watch that on YouTube.
Yeah.
And he had an attitude.
Yeah.
Because she brought her husband in the studio. And he was uncomfortable about
yeah.
that. But he wasn't getting them draws.
No.
So shout out to Selena.
Shout out to her.
As he should. But like these parents, where were they? Why weren't they?
KT, you know? That's my point. My point is that I want you to look at who, like you said. Where were the parents? But who did he make a star? He used
Nobody.
Y'all. He
Nobody.
Used y'all. He didn't make anyone a star. He didn't put any. Who got a Grammy because of him?
They were already artists. Michael Jackson was already an artist. Whitney Houston was already an artist. He worked with people who were already in the industry. Nobody
but
else did.
What
he just
teenager
have to
did
put
he
on?
Make
Nobody.
A star?
Nobody.
None of them.
Okay.
No.
So why tell me where they developed this. I'm going to, you basically, so, and y'all know, you know, I have a problem with this. You sold your daughter.
Right.
For fame?
Mm-hmm.
You didn't protect her. You didn't protect her.
For money.
You didn't protect her innocence. For money?
For money. And again, like I said.
And then when you couldn't get your hands back on your daughter, now you mad.
Now it's a problem.
Now it's a problem.
But again.
But it wasn't a problem when she was on stage or backstage.
But I said this during the pre-show. Not all parents are good parents. I mean, let's just really not get this twisted. We acting like, oh my God, there's their parents. They're going to protect her. Not all parents are good parents.
No.
Parents are people. What's up, Keys? Parents are people. That not all parents are good parents.
Hey, Malik.
There are good parents. There are bad parents.
Right.
There are some parents where they are driven by money. They are driven by fame. They are driven by
attention.
At the
expense of whomever.
They are driven at the expense of whoever. It doesn't matter if it's their children. It doesn't matter if it's their own offspring and flesh and blood. None of that matters whatsoever. So for these parents that let their kids go and let their little girls go.
I'm so confused.
They figured, I hope my child gets to come up.
Well, when? How long do it take for a come up?
Listen.
How long do it take for a come up?
Listen.
And tell me, if there's a parent. What
exactly.
music are you producing? I like to see what y'all been working on when I've been sending my daughter here all this time.
Well, you see,
what y'all working
well,
on?
You see the last one. You see the last.
One of them was asking those questions.
That's my point.
But
no.
You see the last little girl. He slept with her the first day. the last little 17-year-old, they said when they went through her text message that he had slept with her the first day. So you mean to tell me nobody knew? It was still like, no, he slept with my 17-year-old the first day, but he's still going to put out an album for her?
I just want to know where the album is.
Like, we just...
Where's the music? Robert, somebody tell me where the music is.
Parents.
Tell me.
No, parents.
Let me hear what she been working on in your studio.
Parents.
Because I need to know. Is it 6 months? 1 year? What are we doing here? Or is anybody else collaborating with this? Like, I'm sorry, y'all. Everybody failed them.
Everybody
failed. And I'm sorry. And I'm going to tell y'all this. And I don't care who feels this way. Everyone in that video failed. Mm-hmm. Every parent failed. Mm-hmm. Everybody that was in his camp failed them. Everybody who decided to keep it a secret or mm-hmm. aid and abet him, they are at fault. Mm-hmm. Because let me tell you, everybody that knows, everybody that knew, you tell me, the minute that Aaliyah was 14 and that door slang opened and you saw her having sex with him, I'm telling the parents, I'm telling everybody, you will not have that little girl.
Now, sis, we know what kind of parents we are and we know the world we live in. Mm-hmm. Now, let's gear this towards the entertainment industry, okay? Entertainment industry where anything goes. Mm-hmm. The entertainment industry where you get a lot of passes on a lot of stuff.
You just won't pass on my daughter.
Yeah, not on your child. However, them people ain't telling nothing. Because them people have made this entertainment industry their life. And because they have made it their life and because they have made it their livelihood, they are not speaking up.
And let me tell you what I believe. Let me tell you what I believe. R. Kelly's exist everywhere. And let me tell you something. When you sell your soul like that, I am a firm believer in what goes around comes around. Karma, what you reap what you sow and all that stuff. There are R. Kelly's everywhere. You can't tell me that's not going to come back to you. It will.
We gonna leave this in the entertainment industry because you got a whole lot of
generational
your favorite artists.
Oh, I agree.
I agree.
And don't get me wrong. There were people that knew. Like, come on. Like they brought up Jay-Z and Foxy.
But Jay-Z said a long time ago. He said, "Y'all don't see nothing. Something wrong with that man." Jay-Z said that in an interview a long time ago. He said, y'all don't see that something is wrong with that man.
But there's something wrong with you because you was with Foxy Brown.
Oh, I don't know.
She was a kid.
Like, I don't know that.
You
listen, all I'm saying is, I don't know that. But what I am saying
is, it's all over.
All I am saying is, entertainment industry has completely different set of rules. So what you may see around
Misha
here,
Hilton and P. Diddy. She had a kid at 16 by him. Their first son.
Justin.
16. Don't matter. It don't matter to me.
But this is what I'm saying to you.
I get what you're saying. It's legal some places. But all I'm saying is,
But you're proving my point that it's commonplace.
Yes.
And if you're in entertainment, this is commonplace. Whether it's radio, whether it's TV, whether it's music, whether it's acting, every single last one of these celebrities, not every single last one, so I'm not going
to
say that, you have a lot of them have stories of things that happened when they were trying to get on. Even Lupita came out and was talking about, what's the one that they just got, they took down? What's the one they just took down?
Yeah.
The guy?
Uh-huh.
The white guy.
Yes.
What's his name? Somebody tell me.
No, the other one.
No. He was a pedophile.
I know who you're talking about. I can't think of his name.
What's the guy? The big guy. That was the big. Who? Yes.
Harvey Weinstein.
Harvey Weinstein.
Yes.
Even Lupita said when she was first trying to get on, and Lupita's what, 35, 36? When she was first trying to get on, he said, oh, well, come to my house first. And she was like, okay. She thinking she going to his house for a meeting. And he was like, no, come to my bedroom. Mm. And she said, she was like, okay. And then she said she went to his bedroom and now he's touching on her. And she was like, oh, it's this part of the entertainment industry. She's like, yeah, nah, we not doing that. No, we're not doing that. So the fact of the matter is unfortunately, in this entertainment industry, you're going to have a lot of people who are not going to speak up. Again, that does not make them less guilty, because I believe everybody in that video, including that personal assistant, including the one that was blacked out that had a different voice, you go to jail, you go to jail.
Everybody go to jail.
You go to jail.
Everybody go to jail. Because you're not going to tell me. You're not going to tell me.
Trish. Can you tell Trish about what I said with the flyer?
I'm not. You're not going to tell me that you guys got this stories. You're coming out with the stories after the fact.
Right.
You're coming out with these stories where there are a million females damaged already.
The assistant said, we used to fly girls in and out all the time. This is what I want to say, the N-word, and I want to be ignorant. You understand what I'm saying? I want to be like, what?
Then, even with, was he the assistant, the one who signed off on?
Yes, he signed off on Aaliyah getting married.
Yeah, after that, I wanted so bad to talk to her. You didn't sign the papers. What do you?
Would you want to talk to her and say?
About?
You knew she was 15. You knew she was pregnant. You knew all of that. You knew all of that. And the fact of the matter is that you allowed this to happen. And then, like I said, when he said, yeah, we used to fly girls in and out all the time. What, you, are you high? Saying this?
Yeah. Like, go to jail, too.
Go to jail, too.
And you go to jail. Okay, so tell me. Let's talk about, are you guys, let me read some things.
Because ain't no way that hotel door would not have been kicked in, that damn studio in Chicago would be burnt down. Everyone, people who came across him in passing, he said, everybody got an F. If that was my daughter, I'd be singing a new song, whooping R. Kelly ASS. Daniel says, yo, I'm stunned.
This is my thing. So they didn't produce no music, this, that, and the other. They're all damaged, whatever. You guys are coming at with it after the fact. Now, what do you guys feel, and this is not a trick question, but what do you guys feel about the wife?
Andrea Kelly.
What do you think? Yeah, mixed feelings? Or?
I mean, I watched, well, she was 19 when she married him. So in my eyes, she was a child too. Because, you know, I have a child that's older than 19.
Right, right.
So in
and
my
you know eyes, the mentality of,
I know the mentality of a 19-year-old girl who is a dancer on tour.
My mind said this, she'll starting, still be in jail.
Starting to make money with this man. And unfortunately, as little girls, we put, you know what, let's just be honest, as women, we put men on these pedestals and we put them up here, and oh God, if I can get him, or if I can do this. You got 40-50 year old women who still saying, ooh, if I can get him, blah 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 blah. So let's just be honest about it.
Yeah.
So her being 19 already on tour with him, and then him actually turning around and then paying her some attention and then marrying her. She was on that show with Eddie Murphy's ex-wife.
Yes.
And she always said that she was abused, and she was just like, you know, I can't even go into the level of abuse. Da, 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 da. I believe her story. I believe she was abused. I believe she got out when she felt like it was time for her to get out. Mm-hmm. And like she said in there, she was like, there was no child support because he stopped paying it. I wasn't in it for the money because he stopped giving me the money once I left him. I believe her. Let me tell you who I am mad at, though. I'm mad at the 35-year-old DJ. I'm mad at the 35-year-old DJ who started dating him and then allowed herself to be moved to the house and locked up in the room. I'm going to take a sip. You know why I'm going to take a sip?
Why?
Because number one, she's a 35-year-old DJ. And we do a talk show. Whether you know it or not.
Are you a DJ?
We sitting. Yeah. No. But we sitting here right now. Mm-hmm. We do a show. You know what I'm saying? We're a little older than 35, like that much. You understand what I'm saying? So when you 35, right? That means you probably saw the piss tape. I'm just saying. You know what
you
I mean?
You had to.
I saw it.
You had to.
You know what I'm saying?
I saw it too.
That was a big thing in our era.
That was a big thing in our era. It was huge.
I saw it.
It was like, oh my God, who got it?
Right. I saw
this
it.
This is before and internet I'm, was like,
and I'm,
you know.
And I'm being honest with you. I saw the tape. I saw the tape back then. I saw the tape back in 2001, 2002. Okay?
Hey, Kelly.
So you 35. You work in the music industry, which means you have heard every single rumor.
There's no rumor you didn't hear.
Like you said, and this is before social media, you have heard every single rumor. behind the scenes stuff. Do we hear behind the scenes stuff here?
All the time.
We hear behind the scenes stuff about celebrities
all the time.
All the time.
I mean, we've encountered some things with celebrities.
Listen, we ain't going into that right now.
Okay, just saying, we have.
I'm just saying, we're not going
to go. We've encountered a whole lot of things.
We're not going in that, sis. I'm just saying, we're not, sis.
We're aware.
We are aware.
And I ain't sleeping with nobody to get nowhere, and you ain't either.
Me neither.
I won't allow her.
Listen.
I won't allow her. And she won't allow me.
Listen.
Would you be banging down the door if I was in the cult? Let her out.
Get out of there with Robert.
I'm just telling you.
Get out of there with Robert.
I'm just telling you.
Okay?
I'm just telling you.
But this is my point.
Where Toy at?
This is my point.
They would have to lock me.
Did she walk off with him?
Wait, we all going to the bed. This is the buddy system. This is what we do. No, seriously. Because they kick it to her all the time.
Can we get back to my point?
I'm just saying.
Can we get back to my point?
They kicked it to me. They kicked it to you.
Let me tell you, I could actually tell you some stories about celebrities and some of our favorite artists and songs.
Yes.
And when you get around them and the kinds of stuff that they do, and they be trying to fill
it's
you
a little
up
different.
And do all kinds of stuff. And some of my favorite songs from childhood now, when I'm like, mm-mm. because he tried to fill me up, or this one did fill me up in an interview.
Yes.
So I can't even go into that. Right. But what I'm saying is, she was
35. So she saw the P-tape. And she knew about Aaliyah.
She saw the P-tape.
And she knew about Aaliyah.
Mm-hmm. But she said to herself, self,
not me.
He gonna treat me different.
Not me.
You understand what I'm saying?
She said, not me.
She said, he gonna treat me different. So then when you was locked up in the black room.
Were you the same? You wasn't spinning no more. Were you the same? I'm so confused at how you allowed.
How were you hoodwinked, sis? When he moved you to the house, and you saw.
What did you think?
Wait. And it was like.
And you woke up.
Wait. And it was like a jail cell because you walked past a house with rooms full of other different women and girls.
Right. Did you just say you wanted to DJ then? You just wanted to play the song, not beat the song?
And you said...
You ain't want to play the song.
You said... What did you... How did you do that to yourself?
Okay.
The young girls, again, I don't care if it's illegal 18, 19, or if it was 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. That is what it is, because the mentality of young girls is very different. But Nick... Ooh. But uh-huh. Female...
Transparent.
Female, you was 35. Can we take a sip on that? Okay. Mm-hmm. I got to sip to the 35. Okay?
What in your right mind?
What were you thinking?
What in your right mind possessed you as a DJ?
At 35.
At 35 years old.
At 35.
Like you said, I'm recapping. You heard about the
people. You heard about Aaliyah. Okay.
Here we go.
Okay.
You heard about Aaliyah.
Right.
You know about Aaliyah.
Right.
You heard about the P-tape.
You saw the P-tape. You saw the tape. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you for... You saw, hey mom. You saw the P-tape.
Okay.
And now all of a sudden,
okay,
sis, you was like, not me.
He gonna be different.
You was like, not me.
Well, you said no.
I'm exempt because I'm a DJ.
No.
Now, when did you wanna be the song and not play it?
That's all I'm asking.
When did you want to do that?
And then
when did you sign up for that? When you was like, okay. And then when you woke up there, what did you say? So it was real. Fire did burn. Is that it?
Fire is hot.
Sis. I'm confused.
That one.
I'm so confused.
That one.
My cousin said, let me tell you, he found weak women.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He found weak women and girls because 18 to 16 year old would have went for a third of that. Well, yeah. Yeah.
My thing is.
He wasn't the only one that was peeing.
Right. See, my
You're
thing.
Absolutely right.
My thing is his wife, because she met him and married him at 19.
Yes,
I get that. Then after she had three kids, unfortunately, when we have children by somebody, we do some of the craziest stuff. We make decisions that we would not normally make. But now that you got your children involved, you're like, oh my God, no matter if it looked right, wrong, or indifferent.
Even some of the things I did at 19 and 20, when I look at my 19-year-old, I'm like, no, he can't. I was a parent at 20. I could not see my son with a baby. I can't see it. I can't see my daughter at a baby at 19, 20. not just because of this generation, just because I
they're not mature.
They're not mature enough, but also like if I could do it all over again, right. I would wait.
Of course.
You understand what I'm saying? Course. So I wouldn't want my kid to walk in the same lines as me. But I damn sure am not selling my child to no man. I don't care what stardom you have, and I don't care what you're promising them. I am not selling my child. So, like I said from the beginning of the show, every single person on that tape, everybody that got the story, we are looking at R. Kelly, but I want to look at his entourage. I want to look at the people in his life. I want to look at the people that facilitated this. I want to look at the people that never said anything. I want to look at the people that never saved these girls, because he had to go to sleep. And you mean to tell me he had to go to sleep?
Forget sleep. He was on tour. He left the whole state.
And y'all didn't rescue these girls? No one's thinking that?
He left the state.
Come on, y'all.
He ain't always Chicago. Y'all. He ain't always in Atlanta. Come on. He goes back
and forth. It's everybody, the parents, from the parents that failed them to his entourage that failed them to R. Kelly friends that knew he was doing this to the pastor that laid hands on him that knew he was doing this to every single person involved. May you reap what you sowed into all of those girls' lives. That is my point. That is my problem.
I feel like on that note, we could probably end the show. I don't know what else do you say after that?
Because everybody's at fault. And right. Y'all getting on the show years later, and you got women that are going to raise kids because they're going to have kids.
Oh, but did you see at the end, all of them are married and got kids.
Married and got kids. But do you understand that this affects a generation? Do you understand that this affects a whole generation after? This affects all the lineage after? And you got a bunch of grown, damaged little girls. See, because there's little girls that's damaged inside of there.
Definitely
damaged. There's little girls that's damaged inside of there.
Of course.
So you mean to tell me that you're okay with that? How do you sleep at night? Mm-hmm. How did you sleep at night? You ain't think about your cousins, baby, sister, father, mother, you know, anybody in your family?
No, because he said we used to fly girls in and out all the time.
So you sold your soul for a bag. Mm-hmm. And you ruined them girls' lives for a bag? Nah, I have no respect for anybody. Yes, mm-hmm. they exposed him, but expose yourself. Mm-hmm. Expose yourself. Mm-hmm. Period. Mm-hmm. Expose yourself. Because you at fault. That's you hid this.
KT. KT. I'm going to end this. KT, final thoughts on this topic, because unfortunately our show actually ended about 4 minutes ago.
And tell me they ain't sleep with him too.
Well, but the thing is,
tell me they ain't sleep with him too.
The ones that was probably on
while
there,
he on tour.
The ones that was Stop. On there, mm-mm. it was only a few. But if you listen to everything they say, and if there was a girl in every single room of the studio every single time they went in there, that means there is thousands of girls.
Absolutely key to getting more than money. My aunt said the same
thing. There's thousands of girls that they were with. You know what I mean? So, KT, final thoughts on this, girl.
I'm going to take a page off of what B said.
Okay.
Don't sell your soul for a bag. That was the line right there.
Okay.
That was it.
Okay. That's why I said I feel like we just need to end this on this note right now. Ooh, I feel like we need to end this on this note right now. Queen B, go ahead. Final thoughts. I'm listening.
Sorry, guys.
Don't apologize.
I just have an issue with it all. It breaks my heart because, like, I couldn't watch the last episode because it just did something to me. And I'm tired of just women, black women or just families thinking it's okay for certain things to be swept under the rug. There's certain things, there's damage, and we got to raise kids, y'all. Mm-hmm. And we got to raise generations. Mm-hmm. And if we're broken like we are, like, mm-hmm. how do we do that? Because mm-hmm. there's a little girl trapped inside of all these women, and not just them, but the like over the world. Mm-hmm. They got to raise kids, they got to do careers, they got to do whatever. These are people taking their lives for things like this.
Right.
So I'm just very, very upset about it.
Right.
And I'm very, very adamant in that, you know, ever since my daughter could talk or walk or do whatever, don't touch her. Mm-hmm. I will sit in jail. I will. I will sit in jail. Mm-hmm. Seriously. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. With no, I don't care. Just send me some money when you can. Mm-hmm. But I'm going to tell you right now, for mine, my son and my daughter, no, don't touch them. Mm-hmm. My point is that we got to do better as parents, mm-hmm. and we got to do better with selling our souls for a bag. We got to do better than that. Mm-hmm. Because at the expense, these kids are really, really being affected by this. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm just annoyed. Mm-hmm. I'm annoyed.
I'm going to say this.
Y'all all need to go to jail.
I'm gonna say this, and I said it earlier. We need to explore the molestation and rape culture in us as a people, because again, with R. Kelly, it just so happens to be little girls, but with us as a culture, with us as African Americans, it's not just us as little girls; it's little boys too. And we talked about that earlier in the show. And we need to explore this. It's not okay. It's not okay for your 10-year-old little boy to lose his virginity to his 18-year-old babysitter. Yeah, it's like, oh, it's macho. That is still molestation. Mm-hmm. It is not okay. That's not okay. That is molestation. It's not okay that we sit in and we make jokes. Don't go by Uncle So-and-so room. Uncle So-and-so, da-da-da-da-da. That is not okay. We need to start. We need to face it. And unfortunately, I feel like our older generation, the generation that precedes us, absolutely, is the generation of don't say nothing that goes on inside of this house. Don't talk that's about nothing that goes on outside of this house. Don't say da-da-da-da. You know, that they were that generation, but we are a new generation and we are a different generation. And we are a generation that is talking about more. We are a generation that is aware of a lot more and we're speaking up about a lot more. And we need to get to the point where this is, it's not okay.
None of it.
It's not okay.
None of it.
None of this is okay. And we have to address it from the core. We have to address it from us as a people. I don't know where it began. I don't know how this got
Color
into
Purple
our culture.
Is one of those movies.
We got, I mean,
remember Color Purple? Do y'all remember when she was given? He wanted the other one.
She was 14.
Not an abnormal story.
Unfortunately, it is a part of
we
the
all
culture.
Watched it.
Unfortunately, it's a part of the culture, but it is not okay. And we need to make sure
that we
stand
you
up
have
for
the
it.
Book.
We need to stand up for it and make sure we know it's not okay. It's not okay in our little girls and it's not okay in our little boys. We need to have the conversation. We need to have the actualization. We need to have the realization that none of this is okay. And that's my final thoughts on this. Unfortunately, everybody, we have to end the show. We have to end this discussion. We have to end this topic. We are 9 minutes over our show right now. And it is our first show of the year. It is 2019. We are here every single Tuesday from 7 to 8:30 right here on BKS1 Ready to Out Show. It's Only Women Wear High Heels. It is myself, Chanel, and of course Queen B. We have DJ KT the Voice on the ones and twos, and we have DJ Sassy, who is also in. We are a family. We are here. We do this every single week. The same show, different content, same show, different content, different shows every single week. We have Dr. Hardy, who is coming in next week. Absolutely. And we can talk about this some more with Dr. Hardy.
Yeah, we'll definitely delve into this a little
Dr.
bit more.
Dr. Hardy, we'll talk about that. And she's going to get our lives right, get our minds right, so that we can progress into 2019. We also have Do It All Dupree Kelly from Lords
of
the Underground, who is going to be in the studio with us. We have a number of guests, wonderful guests, who are going to be in the studio with us just this month alone. We're not even talking about all of 2019. We're just talking about January. We are going to have a hot show. Thank you to my cousin Tay, who is saying we are fire and she loves us right now.
Thank you
to Jess, who is talking about those t-shirts. Listen, no whack-ish in 2019. We are about to patent that.
Yes.
We are really going to do t-shirts. We're going to sell them.
We got some
orders. We got some smalls. We got some mediums. We got some extra larges. We got some extra, extra larges. No whack-ish in 2019. We not taking it, and we don't want you guys to take it either. That is our show for tonight. It's BKS1 Radio. It's the Al Show. DJ KT the Voice, go ahead and take us
away.
Love
you guys.
Thank you guys.
Thank you
we love
so
you guys
much.
For listening and watching.
You're listening to WBKS1.com. Chanel and Queen B. Only women wear high heels. Sing it one more time. Only women wear high heels.
www.bks1.com. What's your name?